Welcome to the recording studios. Conditions in here today aren't what we'd hoped, but we're certainly going to have a bash at producing another Smasheroo Christmas record. Now, around me I've got gathered one or two of the boys, and here, first of all, to speak is Ringo. Come over here, Ringo, mate. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, once again, I'd like to thank you all for the cards and letters and all the gifts you've sent us and for buying our records and for being just great fans again. Well, that's all from me at the moment. I'll hand you over to George.
Hello, everybody. Well, this is our third Christmas record now. And everything else is still nice, isn't it? I'll hand you over to John.
John.
It's been a long time since I've spoken to you, and that's about all.
John, I understood you had a couple of words to say to us.
It's been a long time since I've had a chance to speak to you on this level, and that's about all.
Well, well, it looks like it's been another
Smasheroo year.
Smasheroo year. And so, we'll just wait for a sound effect then.
Don't forget to thank him about the film.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you know, the recording studio here today, we've had a little couple of mishaps, and the plumbing went astray. We were hoping that we could get a little bit more out of the boys today, but I understand they had a bad night last night.
Pretty soon, Henry was to find out that his wife had been made with him for the former butcher of the village. Yeah. She, of course, left unheard of. The next thing we knew, that Harry was down with the flu. Well, of course, we knew he hadn't been out, so where had he caught it? Obviously off her. Now, she was carrying it around like a bad thing. Over to the studio.
Thank you. Well, back here in the studio, conditions have definitely improved. Conditions have definitely improved, and it is certainly now looks as though we are going to get this show on the road. The boys are now tuning up for their record, and it sounds like George is in pretty good voice. It sounds like he is. Is he?
That's the first chance I've ever speak to
him. He's not.
Oh, man, isn't
it? Oh, you can't
someone
think
of something,
you
know.
Well, that's what I said. I said, don't put
I know
it
you did
we
say
thought
that,
of something that would stand here like a soft Henry.
Well, fans,
this isn't the baby we used in the test, but we got Mrs. Williamson to slice up a fresher baby. And here there's the baby now in the process of being sliced. There you go.
Now, as you see, the smaller slices are the only slices that are allowed into the box. Now, all the bigger slices, like the limbs and the head, we keep out and we use in various other meat products, such as PAL, Keno meat, and other things like that. But you, the buyers, must realize that only the small part of this child will end up in your family frozen pack in your shops from
It's
Friday.
Not a very pretty sight, I can tell you. It's not a very pretty sight seeing a little baby sliced up on a slicing machine. It's not too pretty, folks.
Do you mean those little sore white spots in the back? Oh, yes, I use Gumstead's arseholes.
Oh, yes, right.
Well, yes, I think it's time to put the baby to sleep, eh, Ringo? Come along, Daz. Come along.
Well, down here at the station, the constable has just given me their reports for the evening, and the winner of the personality report for this evening, the best report, and neatness taken into account, was PC Lennon. PC Lennon, please come forward and collect your this year's award for the neatness personality report as down at the station.
Well, thanks very much for the prize. I must say I'm very happy to have it. It's the first time I've won a policeman. I'm going to look after him like he was my own.
We shouldn't have us laughing on it, though. It's
cut that, cut that.
Thank you very much.
The next contestant, stand up on the winner, please.
Now, I've come along there tonight from Blackburn, and I was there the other night at the Labour Club, and I saw this fella there juggling. And
you got three sons?
No.
You said no?
No, I didn't.
And who have you brought along tonight?
Well, Now, this fellow was at the Labour Club, you see, and I thought he'd stand a good chance.
He was at the, isn't that wonderful, ladies and gentlemen, the Labour Club?
The Labour Club, yes. And yeah. So here he is. Here he is.
And what is his name?
Yes, well, we've had trouble finding his name due to the fact that he lost his birth certificate when he was born, you see.
Oh, yes. So anyway, for whoever he may be, it's knocking again. It's all very well to you to say we're going on the cheap holiday this year. Rowing boat, that's pushing it. I mean, in the middle of the Mediterranean, we're getting a cruise, all right, we're getting a tan, yes. But is it worth it, the rowing boat?
The main thing is we've got away.
We've certainly got away. Where are we going? Hey! Hey! Who did that? Who? Hey! Who is it? Will you stop it? People trying to get to sleep, are you? Oh, yeah, you were right, weren't you, about this cruise, yes? Ended up in a railroad sidling. Ended up in a railway siding, yes. Oh, well, and in a rowing boat. Well, you and your cheap holidays. What is it? Hey!
I can't really make out what
they are. No, I can't make out what they are yet, John, but you never know. There may be something there.
And now it's Starkey into the right corner with the left swing, and he's over to Lennon, and Lennon is on there, and he's over there now again, and he's hitting him with the bell, yes, and the ref's coming in now, and he's over there now.
One and one is two. I'll get that bum in two.
One, two, here, five, six, seven. I'll get that bum in seven.
Yes, it was a wise man who said Christmas comes but once a year. And when it comes, it brings good cheer. Certainly come again this year. Where's all the good cheer we used to know? Maybe we're not pulling together, ladies and gentlemen.
And to finish the job we set off to do.
Maybe we ought to all pull together with one concerted effort. And put our party in the lead. If we could just keep going for another couple of hours, I'm sure we'd get something.
Has anybody mentioned Christmas yet?
We could certainly mention it on the next...
Yes, mentioned it.
I think so far we've got a lot of little quickie shots from going from different sounds that we'll probably use, you know, about 5 or 10 seconds of each, just sort of bring them banging straight out.
Yeah. You got any humans? The new record.
Right, put that on, that's lovely. Oh, copyrights and things.
Oh, watch the copyrights.
Oh, these are sound
effects. It's a tune, though. Copyright.
That we'll be able to use it. Who wrote it? Has it got?
It's that. It's what's in there? No, it's not copyright. It's those old.
It's
thingy.
The Star Spangled Banner thing.
Oh, corner. Right on the record. Great. Can't be copyrights on the record.
Oh, oh, all right. Well, we'll sing it then.
Dixie,
I wish you was a Dixie.
We'll do it again. We'll do the
music. All right.
You know,
it's no good singing it. You have to do something over it.
It's on.
Welcome, everybody. Was the festival of pipe music. Here, in the Bavarian Alps, we always hold this festival once every 2 hours.
Hello, Fritz. We're having a bit of a loon-up. Are you coming over?
Yeah. That was one of our German pipe players saying a few words to you. We've got him here on this occasion of Christmas, and he's going to say a few words, and now Fritz Schwedlund. And now Fritz Schwedlund.
Hello, Fritz. We're having a bit of a loon up. You coming over?
Can't we have one sort of in the distance?
What's in the distance? What us or the...
Hey? We wish you Merry Christmas. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Irish Deadfoot. This is the annual prize giving, which we hold every 2 hours. This is the prize giving now, where we're going to present the prize to the farmer with the most promise this year, Mr. Lennon.
Thank you. Well, my cow, as you know, it's one of the best of Hereford of the crossbreed. It's well known, it's tiling of the kettle and the long horn. Very breeded and a lot of luck to you, so thank you.
Thank you very much.
We don't seem to know anybody here, do we? is that old Charlie over there?
Yes, I think it is, you know. I think it is.
Hey, Charlie!
Charlie, come over. Come on.
What?
See that bird in the corner, Joe?
All right. That's enough of that. Come on. What are you doing here? Come on. All right, come on. What are you doing here? Come on. What is it one of the three of you doing hanging around here? Is he all right?
I think it was just a scratch, sir. Just a scratch, sir. Just a scratch, sir. I think it was just a scratch, sir. I think it was just a scratch, sir.
Well,
well, what are we going to do, fellas? Come on, we got to pull. We got to pull ourselves together.
John Lennon, sheep farmer, colour consultant, chain gang foreman, fighter pilot, and well-known table tennis wicketkeeper. What are you talking about?
That's the attitude of a defeatist like me.
Bring back the cat, that's what I say. Bring back the cat, that's what I say. And let's get rid of all these mice once and for all.
And we really do want to say thank you for being people in 65.
And for all our birthday cards and for all the letters you've written to us.
For coming to our shows and for collecting our records.
On the second day of Christmas, my true love sent to me. Boo, boo, ba-doo, ba-doo, boo. Bonfire night. Bonfire night. You will notice that the band is playing music which is out of copyright, so that nobody has to pay any royalties.
Look, I can't read that straight. I mean, if that's what you're waiting for, I can't do it, man. You know, I don't dig it.
It's aesthetic.
All right, so, you know, make it stupid, but make it sort of good stupid.